Hello, welcome back. Wokafini here. Today we're reacting to One Piece chapter 1014. First off, the only thing I got spoiled on it was I think we're coming back to Luffy. That's all I know. Like, I just saw like a panel of him like falling, like him still falling, kind of, something like that. That's my fault for not remembering that spoilers come out like last night. So yeah, sorry about that. Yes, we left. What did we leave off on? We left off. Oh, with the Zeus stuff. Yeah. So Zeus is kind of dead, but he's also maybe not. Like, it's kind of like a confusing thing. Like, I've seen different things. Like, I have seen people, like, I've seen most people say, oh yeah, Zeus is dead. But I've also seen people say that, like, Nami absorbed him into her climate act, which, like, I could see that happening. I wouldn't be mad if that happened. But, like, it's just, like, I don't know. I just don't know. Nami had some cool moments. Big Mom had some cool moments. Then we also had Luffy falling off of Onigashima at the end. I honestly don't remember that much of last chapter, not gonna lie. And you can also see there's rats in the background. They haven't been out of their cage in a long time, so I figured I'd let them out. The reason they're not, I don't let them out of the cage so much is because I'm allergic to them. It's like, if they touch my skin, I break out in hives. So that's not fun. So like, I can only have them out sometimes, and it's not when I'm on my bed. So yeah. So sometimes when I'm recording, I let them out just for fun. I guess let's just get started. One Piece chapter 1004, a lifelong ham actor. Cool. You know, relive the Onigashima War in volume 99, available on June 4th. Oh yeah, because we had the volume cover, the volume 99 dropped, or like the cover did, and apparently volumes 99, 100, and 101 are all gonna be like connecting volumes, like the arts on them, the top on the front. That's gonna be fun. What's the cover request? Log gathering his wits in front of a Byobu folding screen depicting a tiger. Translator note: cover inspired by a Japanese folktale about Ikkyu-san, a young Buddhist monk who is tasked with using his wits to capture a Byobu tiger. Okay, cool, I guess. It's a Japanese thing, I don't understand that much. Okay, cool. That's always like this first like couple panels. Onigashima snakes through the sky. You managed to coat your blows with conqueror's haki, Kaido saying. And you see him still falling off. But your technique left a lot to be desired. What was it again? Gomu Gomu no? Warororor. Seems like you couldn't be Joy Boy either. So does Kaido know stuff? He probably knows stuff. Ring 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 ring. Gotcha. Kaido-sama, I have located Momonosuke. Who's saying that? Oh, I'm on my way. Bao Huang. I think that's how you say her name. Yes, sir. Announce the outcome of my battle throughout Onigashima. Oh, it's not everyone's gonna hear it. I'm probably gonna get to see what's happening with other fights too. That's cool. Castle interior, third floor. Young Master Yamato has been spotted, openly carrying Momonosuke. Something's wrong. What happened to the shackles? That's right. I'm not a prisoner anymore. I am Odin. What? First floor addict, Shinobu. Yes. It seems. I cannot afford to die, Momonosuke is saying. So he's reading stuff in the journal. Like, he's like, like, we don't know what's in the journal. Like, I wouldn't be surprised if Odin was like, oh yeah, here's what the Void Sentry, here's what Joy Boy, here's what the last ancient weapon was, here's what, like, everything. I wouldn't be surprised if we did it, but like, I kind of don't want that to happen. Shinobu's saying, what? What are you saying? Of course you can't. And then Momonosuke starts like, he cries out, what is this? Who are you? Huh? What now? Oh, that's interesting. Maybe something about his link with Kaido? Or his link with Luffy? We don't really know, but there's a lot of stuff we don't know. Skull Dome. Live floor. Oh, we're coming back to Queen and all of them. And we see Queen being Whoa, get him, Chopper and Monsun. So we see Chopper in Monster Point grabbing Queen by the head and just like, while Queen's in his Brachiosaur form and just like throwing him like that's really cool. And like, it's just like the size difference. Wow. And you see a bunch of beast pirates. Chopper has like a bunch of Like at least seven arrows in his back too. That's bad, but he's a doctor, he'll be fine. Queen serves you right. Yeah, he and Chopper's like wheeze, wheeze. And the queen's like upside down. Mwahaha, what's the matter, Tanuki? You're pretty short of breath for someone who's supposed to be winning. Wheeze, wheeze. And Perro Sparrow. Oh, the arrows are from Perro Sparrow. All the arrows in Chopper's back and all in Samurai. Okay, that makes sense. I didn't see that. And cuckoo, cuckoo, cuckoo. Let's see how long you can keep that up, Perolene. None of my attacks are working on him, Chopper's saying. My gigantification may last longer now, but I have less than 10 minutes left. Sure, that won't do. That's Caesar's laugh. Oh, so we're all oh, so we have a flashback with between Chopper and Caesar. Wait, I'm actually really here for this. Gigantification only lasts a meager 3 minutes, Caesar's saying. Why bother? But if I can stay in Monster Point any longer, then what? Are you really that delicate? I thought you were supposed to be a pirate. What did you say? Rumble Ball? You call this a formula? You should just let me design the drug instead. If you gather the ingredients, I'm sure we could increase your time limit of your transformation to 30 minutes. Sure, there'll be some added risk involved, but you're not scared, are you? So he is gonna have like an upgraded Rumble Ball designed by Caesar. Like, I'm kind of here for that. I'm kind of here for that. And so we're gonna cut about out this flashback. Queen's doing his laser thing. Black coffee. I wonder what that attack means. Black coffee. That's a cool name, but I don't know what it means. I mean, obviously it's black coffee, but like, why did you pick that for an attack name? And Perro Sparrow's shooting up like just another bundle of arrows. He's gonna rain down candy arrows again. Cuckoo, cuckoo, cuckoo. Take cover. Dot 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 dot. We see someone who's is that Bo Huang? Lands, Marys. Scatter mode. Clack, 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 clack. And so we see Bo Huang. Then we see a cat. Then we see a person. Then we see like a lizard, all with like the mask thing on. Ooh, this is a double page spread too, so we're probably gonna get cut to other people. We have news for everyone in Onigashima. A battle result. Straw Hat Luffy, the rebel with the highest bounty. Luffy Taro-san has been defeated. What? Luffy? That's impossible. And we see like Chopper like hesitates at that news, and then Queen's neck extends and bites him in the chest. And Marco's like, Straw Hat? Frankie, what was that? After Straw Hat Luffy was slaughtered by Kaido-sama, and we cut back to who's who and Jinbei fighting. Ha ha ha, what's good? What good news? Who's saying? His corpse was dropped to the darkest depths of the night sea. The Kozuki Samurai and your captain have failed. And see Luffy like floating like in the water. So he's underwater now, so that's bad. Then we see Boss Hyo and I forget the other guy's name, but he was the guy who's gonna cut Hyo's head off. Kinemon and the others too? Who wants to be next? Do any of you have what it takes? Kaido saying. Kaido's on his way to oversee cleanup. And he's like, Lin Lin made this massive hole. But he's willing to graciously accept your surrender. And you see Law like gritting his teeth, like he's angry. Like, and then we see Big Mom and Kid fighting, and she's like, Mama, Mama, do you hear that? And Kid's like, I care about that moron. And then you see Nami, Tama, and Usopp. Wow, big bro Luffy. If you raise your hands and swear fealty, fealty, I don't know how to say that. Then we cut back to Robin and Brooke fighting Black Maria. Your life will be spared, and you'll be welcomed to the fold. And then we see Sanji and Zoro. Zoro waking up from his like coma basically, and they're both saying, "Screw that." I'm slaving that entire double page spread. That's like amazing. Like that's like I love that. But I wonder how they're gonna react to that. Like are they just gonna be like blindly like, "Oh yeah, Luffy's fine. Luffy's fine." But like this is the new world and you're fighting a Yonko, so you kind of have to be worried. So first floor passage leading up to the attic. It is high time Wano submitted. And you see Kanjuro all alone. You are losing a fighting battle. It's still the Mary. The victor has already been decided. Straw Hat Luffy has. Oh, so it's like cutting back. Okay, cool. And then we see, what is this? We see Kiku in Kinemon and a big shinobu. Momonosuke-sama, this is one of those Marys, right? If it's here. That means this is bad, Momonosuke-sama. Momonosuke-sama. It's Kinemon saying this. Momonosuke-sama, what happened? And Momonosuke saying, Kinemon, you have to tell everyone. Huff, huff. And then Shinobu says, we need to deal with this frog. And then Odin comes, oh, Kanjuro, that's messed up. So then Odin comes up, but it's obviously, what if we're duped by Oda? What if this is actually Odin and we think it's Kanjuro? Hey, Momonosuke, it's been too long. And Shinobu's like, it can't be. Odin-sama, Shinobu, it's good to see you. And Kiku's like, enough already. Father! And Momonosuke's saying, it's not him. Cover your eyes. Father! Stand back, Shinobu. He's a fraud. How dare you attempt to pull this sick farce again? Is something wrong, Kiku? You seem angry. After what you did to Ashura-san. And he said, even the sharpest sword becomes dull, one pointed out a friend. What are you doing, Kiku? He seems like genuinely, like, afraid. Stop calling me that while wearing his face, Kanjuro. You can't be serious. I took you and Izo in, remember? Where are your parents? And she starts crying. And she holds up her sword. How could you raise a sword at me? And the Odin clone, whatever, stabs Kiku through the heart. Yeah, Shinobu's like, why, like, face is like pure shock, Kinemon, pure shock, and you see Kiku, I couldn't bring myself to cut him, Kin-sama, and Odin turns into Kanjuro. Turnabout is a fair play, you gave me a fatal wound earlier, after all, wheeze, Kanjuro, Kiku, wah, Kanjuro. And we see, and Kinemon is holding Kiku's body. And she's like, Kin-sama, Kiku! Forgive me, the lingering snow is finally melting, so I can tell that dawn is near. What are you saying? Wano's dawn will still shine in the afterlife. Kin? Kanjuro! Yeah, and then Kinemon cuts Kanjuro, like, through the chest. So he's probably dead now. We're still not done. This has been a long chapter. And he cuts him down. Cuck. Good. Someone had to close the curtains on my life. Odin-sama, are you sure about taking a freak like him in? Wahaha. It's like a flashback for Kinemon and Kanjuro's relationship. And you're a perfect fit for that role. After all, while I was performing on stage, you were my best friend. And he drops dead. ... and both Shinobu and Momonosuke are crying, and I assume Kinemon's crying too, because now Kiku's dead probably too. I couldn't really see this panel is confusing. So apparently Kaido breaks through the roof and Kaido Shinobu and Akin saying, Shinobu, take Momonosuke-sama and run. Understood. And then, Kaido's, like, about to hit Shinobu, like, his teeth gritting. And then Kanjuro goes to, block it. And what am I even looking at? So, I, like, instantly got drained from reading this panel. So it looks like Kaido takes his Kanabo and puts it right on Kinemon. Like, you can't even, like, you can't see the upper half of his body at all. Like, that's how bad it is. But there's also a sword. Oh! He goes to take his sword, and then the blades break. Smash. And Momonosuke's crying because he had to watch that. Kinemon! Onigashima looms over the skies of mainland Wano. Moment by moment. No break next week, thankfully, but, like, at what cost? At what cost? Like, if you've watched some of my other videos, like, when stuff bad like this happens, you know I don't get sad. Like, I don't cry, I don't get sad. That's not me. I just get really emotionally drained, and I feel like I felt it, like I felt my energy like instantly just plummet when I read that. And I think you could maybe hear it in my voice too. Yeah, that's fun, I guess. Like we have no break, but at what cost, you know? Three characters died this chapter. Kinemon died, Kiku died, and Kanjuro died. That's three of the scabbards taken out, all in one, like literally within half a chapter. Like, what the heck? What the heck? How do I even respond to this? I guess let's just go through the chapter. Yeah, so Luffy keeps falling and he ends up going into the ocean. So, what can save him? I don't know. I think he's gonna like the reason I like One Piece so much is like I can in like when stuff like this happens, like if it was any other author, I feel like I'd be worried. Like if this was Horikoshi, I would be so worried. If it was like who else? Like just like if it was like almost any other author, I would have been so worried. But like with Oda, I can trust him. Like when stuff like this happens and like I just feel like I leave it in Oda's hands, you know? So like I don't there's lots of theories that I can pull. Like he washes up on shore and then Onigashima crashes and he could do nothing. Or like the octopus from the beginning of Wano saves him. Or the revolutionary comes. Or Yamato unlocks his fruit. Or Momonosuke saves him with his dragon fruit. Or just like there's so or the Big Mom Pirates. Like there's so many things you could theorize on. But at the end of the day, it's just like I just trust Oda. So yeah. Yeah, like the Mary is relaying all of that information, and you just see like everyone react to it. Like, that was just, I love that so much. Like, that was just amazing. Like, you see all the Straw Hats, you see Marco react to it, we see Jinbei react to it, we see Law react to it, we see like Tama react to it, when we see like Zoro and Sanji saying screw that. Like, I just love that so much. Chopper fighting Queen, like, I love that. Like, I don't even know. I don't know what to call the move, but like Chopper just like folding like Queen on top of himself, like in the air. Like I love that so much. And I didn't even catch like Perospero running down the candy arrows. My throat hurts now. I've been talking for 19 minutes and 34 seconds, straight. So my throat hurts. But what was I gonna talk about? Oh, the conversation between Chopper and Caesar. You can't really tell when this happens, but I think it's right after Punk Hazard. Or right after Dressrosa. Yeah, I think it's right after Dressrosa. That kind of makes sense, I guess. But Caesar has bandages on him, so I think that this might be after Punk Hazard. Yeah, like we got like glimpses of all the fights between like Straw Hats. But like now that Luffy's out of the picture, I'm kind of low-key scared that we're not gonna get the continuation of those fights to see what's happening. Like, I want to see the Black Maria fight so bad. And we haven't even cut back to like a full-on like actual Jinbei fight, like since like his fight started. And we had some of the Franky fight, but it was just like we need to cut back to those. Like we do. But I don't know when. But trusting Oda, you know? This was like a really confusing chapter for me to read through. But like, I think I caught myself most of the time. I got really, really confused. Yeah, Kondro, that's really messed up showing up as Odin. And then we have three scabbards all going out at once. And it's just Shinobu left again. Like, it's just Shinobu left carrying on the Kozukis for the second time. Like, that's gonna be so hard for her. Like, I'm honestly not like too sad about it. I'm actually really mad. Like, I'm like so mad that Kiku's dead because like she's one of my favorite One Piece characters. So, like, I'm actually like, I'm not sad about it as I am mad about it. Like, honestly. But yeah. Like, there's a huge, like, stream of something coming off of Kaido's Kanemon when he strikes Kinemon. And I can't tell if that's blood or haki. So, like, it might be blood, honestly. But yeah, both of Kinemon's sword broke. Yeah. That's interesting. I just realized something at the very end of the chapter, like, the last panel. So if we see Onigashima looms over the skies of mainland Wano, but the mainland Wano that it shows is the Udon prison. So like if it touches down in Wano, it's not gonna be that bad if it touches down in the Udon prison, right? So I don't know, that's just something I noticed. But yeah, my throat hurts. I'm gonna record Attack on Titan later too. It's Friday. But yeah, I have a lot of stuff planned this weekend. Like I'm just like I don't know if I will even have time to record like My Hero in Shadow's house on Saturday. Like just so much stuff. But yeah, I've been going on for way too long. The runtime of my recording has been 23 minutes. So it's probably be around 20 minutes long. So yeah, I'll see you guys next time and bye.